Today we are going to cover unit number 4 of basic electronics engineering, that is electronic instrumentation. Now if we deal with the unit number 4, it consists of most important point, that is digital multimeter, function generator, digital storage oscilloscope, power scope, DC power supply, auto transformer, and the last one is analog ammeter and voltmeter. If we classified this unit as a 7 points and if we formulate 7 different questions, the questions are just like: explain a block diagram of digital multimeter in detail, explain the block diagram of function generator. Maybe the question is like, explain the digital storage oscilloscope, that is DSO, and so on. So we have to prepare the 7 questions regarding to unit number 4, that is electronic instrumentation. Now, what is mean by the instrumentation? That the various quantities are measured with the help of the electronic circuit, or you can say the various parameters are measured with the help of the devices, and that devices are nothing but the instruments. So quantities are converted into the electrical signal that we have to measure with the help of the any instrument. So in this unit we have to started with the digital multimeter. Now digital multimeter is used to measure the voltage, current, resistance, and test for the continuity. The digital multimeter, as shown in the PPTs, it shows the selector switch. This type of digital multimeters already we have implemented in our practicals. We are performed the various practicals of our basic electronics engineering by using the digital multimeter, by interfacing it with the other equipments, and we'll use this also. So by selecting the switch, we can select the different parameters, that is voltage, current, resistor, or by selecting the switch we can check the continuity also. So front panel symbols of the digital multimeters are very simple, that is voltage, whether it's DC voltage or AC voltage. The voltage is measured in millivoltage. Current is measured in ampere, milliampere, or microampere. The ranges are given up to which range we have to measure this voltage and current. Then resistance are measured in ohm, kilo ohm, mega ohm, and as usual continuity beeper, means a beep like sound is there when we test the continuity. Now again it consists of the capacitance, diode test, then hertz, how the frequency is measured, cycles per second or hertz, and so on. These all are given on digital multimeter, and already we use the digital multimeter in our practicals. Now there may be question in your NSEM examination: explain the digital multimeter with its block diagram. So block diagram of digital multimeter is consist of constant current source, buffer amplifier, calibrated attenuator, current voltage, current to voltage converter, and attenuator, the rectifier circuit, analog to digital converter, and digital display. These are the main building blocks of digital multimeter. An instrument which is capable of measuring AC and DC voltages, AC and DC currents, and resistances over the several ranges is called the digital multimeter. As shown in the block diagram of the digital multimeter, it is also represented as DMM, capital DMM, digital multimeter. Now we see the most important part in your digital multimeter is rotary switch. It indicates the 5 different positions by making its contact with the position 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we started with the position 1. When its rotary switch is at position 1, it's known for measurement of resistance. The rotary switch is in the position 1 and resistance is connected to the input probes. The constant current source drives a current through unknown resistance. This produces the voltage across the resistance, which is directly proportional to the resistance. It is given to the buffer amplifier and then to analog to digital converter. The analog to digital converter converts it into equivalent digital signal, and it is displayed with the help of the digital display. So whenever the rotary switch of the digital multimeter is at position 1, that is at resistance, that unknown resistance value it display in this digital display by making the buffer amplifier and through analog to digital converter. When that rotary switch is put on the second position, that is AC voltage measurement, the rotary switch is in a position 2 and input AC voltage is applied to probes. It is above the selected range, it is attenuated. If it is above the selected range, it is attenuated with the help of the compensated or that calibrated attenuator. It is rectified to produce the proportional DC voltage and then it is given to analog to digital converter which display it in volts. So in this way the AC voltage is measured at position 2. Similarly at position 3, the rotary switch is in position 3 and unknown current is applied across the input probes. It is converted to proportional voltage using the current to voltage converter. The IV, current to voltage converter, is op amp circuit which is used to convert it into the voltage, and in the same fashion we have to measure the AC current at the position 3. Now at the position 4, when the rotary switch is in the position 4, an unknown DC current is applied across, unknown DC current is applied across the input probe. This is converted to proportional voltage with the help of the current to voltage converter. The voltage is given to analog to digital converter without the rectification, and at this proportional DC current, it gives the value in digital display. Similarly, at the position 5, the rotary switch is in position 5, an unknown voltage is applied across the input probes. It is attenuated and directly given to analog to digital converter without rectification, and the analog to digital convert display its value on digital display. In this fashion, all the 5 positions are covered by means of the buffer amplifier, attenuator, current to voltage converters. For the some positions will require the rectifier circuit. All the signals are finally provided to the analog to digital converter and then it is given to the digital display. In this way the working of the digital multimeter is given. Now if we are use this as a digital multimeter, the various parameters we are going to use, that are AC as well as DC, AC voltage, DC voltage, AC current, DC current, and so on. Now further we deal with some advantages and disadvantages of digital multimeter. As the advantages are considered, it offers automatic output display, it ensures the accuracy, it has auto polarity functions. Now if we deal with the disadvantages of digital multimeter, it does not do well with measurement fluctuation. Sometimes we observe that when we are going to use digital multimeter, the little bit fluctuations are there in the values of voltage, current or the resistor value. So this is the one of the disadvantage of digital multimeter. It is more expensive than the analog type of instrument. It can be difficult to find one for your specific needs. So these are some advantages and disadvantages of digital multimeter. If there is a question, explain the block diagram of digital multimeter. We have to cover this block diagram, explain the all positions for all 5 positions for AC voltage, AC current, DC voltage, DC current and resistance value, explain the analog to digital converter and what are the disadvantages and what are the advantages. Now the next one we have to cover, that is comparison between analog and digital multimeter. If we compare both the multimeters, for the analog external power supply is not required, but if we deal with the digital multimeter, external power supplies are required. There is a better visual indication in analog meter and it is a less observable in digital multimeter. Less effect of noise in analog meters, more effective to the noise to the digital multimeter. then accuracy is less as in analog multimeter, and as digital display is used, so definitely accuracy is more in digital multimeter. The interfacing with other equipment is not done with analog multimeter, but we can interface the digital multimeter with other equipments. Analog meters are simple in construction as we go for the block diagram. It is somehow complicated in construction for digital multimeter. Analog meters are large in size, whether digital multimeters are compact in size. Cost is low, cost is more as compared to analog for the digital multimeter. The precision is low in analog multimeter and high precision is there for digital multimeter. Then mounting limitations are there for analog. There is no any mounting limitations for the digital multimeter. You are anywhere in any position you can use the digital multimeter. So these all are the comparison points between analog and digital multimeter. Maybe there is a question that difference between the analog and digital multimeter. Now the next topic is function generator. We have to go for again the block diagram, explain the block diagram of function generator. A function generator is a signal source that has the capability of producing different types of waveforms as its output signal. The most common output waveforms are sine waves, triangular waves, square waves and sawtooth waves. The frequencies of such a waveforms may be adjusted from a fraction of hertz to several hundred kilohertz. Now the block, if you observe the block diagram of the function generator, is basically consists of frequency control network, constant current supply sources, that is source 1 and source 2, integrator, voltage comparator, multivibrator, resistance diode shaping circuit and output amplifier. In function generator, the frequency is controlled by varying the magnitude of current which drives the integrator. The frequency control voltage is used to regulate the two current sources, namely upper current source and lower current source, that is a constant current supply source 1 and constant current supply source 2. If the current changing the capacitor increases or decreases, the slope of the output voltage increases or decreases respectively. Hence, this controls the frequency. The voltage comparator multivibrator circuit changes the state of the network when the output voltage of the integrator equals the maximum predetermined upper level. Because of this change in a state, the upper current source is removed and the lower current source is switched on. The lower current source supplies opposite current to the integrator circuit. The output of the integrator decreases linearly with time. When this output voltage equals the maximum predetermined upper level, on negative side, the voltage comparator multivibrator again changes the condition of the network by switching off the lower current source and switching on the upper current source. The output voltage of the integrator has the triangular waveform. The frequency of this triangular waveform is determined by the magnitude of the current supplied by upper current source and lower current source. To get the square wave, the output of the integrator is passed through the comparator. The voltage comparator delivered a square wave output voltage of the same frequency as that of the input triangular wave. The sine wave is derived from the triangular wave. The triangular wave is synthesized into sine wave using diode resistance network. In this shaper circuit, the slope of the triangular wave is changed as its amplitude changes. In short, the function generator is basically consists of the frequency control network which control the two constant current supplies. It provide the input to the integrator. Depending upon the change in capacitor's value, whether it increases or decreases, it gives a triangular waveform. The output of the integrator gives you the triangular waveform, and when it's provided through a voltage comparator multivibrator, it gives a square waveform, and provided to the diode shaping circuit, it gives the your sinusoidal waveform. So this is regarding to the block diagram of the function generator. This is the overall working of function generator. The different applications of function generator are, it is used to test the bandwidth of the audio frequency amplifiers using square wave testing method. It is used to generate the different types of waveform such as sinusoidal wave, square wave, triangular wave and sawtooth waveform. It can be used in troubleshooting of various analog as well as digital instruments. It is most extensively used as a signal source for radio receiver and etc. These all are the applications of the function generator. If there is a question, explain the block diagram of function generator with its working, then we have to write down all the working of the function generator, draw the block diagram of the function generator and write down the applications of the function generator. Now next topic we have to start, that is a digital storage oscilloscope, that is DSO. The block diagram of DSO is consist of amplifier, digitizer, memory, analyzer circuitry, waveform construction. These all provided to the vertical plates of the CRT. Then again the triggered and clock circuit are used to give the time base, and time base circuit is provided to the horizontal amplifier. Again it is provided to the horizontal plates of the CRT. This is a structure of digital storage oscilloscope. The waveform to be stored is digitized, stored in a digital memory. The input is provided to the amplifier and amplifier will give it to the digitizer. As long as power is supplied to the memory, the stored waveform can be displayed indefinitely. The digitized waveform can be further analyzed by the oscilloscope. As referring to the block diagram and to understand the working of the DSO, the input amplifier attenuates and amplifies the analog input signal as per the requirement. The amplified analog signal is applied to the digitizer. The digitizer has two blocks, a sampler and an analog to digital converter. The sampler samples the amplified analog signal at regular interval to produce its sampled version, which is discrete signal and represent the input waveform to the next block. The analog to digital converter converts each sample value into an equivalent digital word, and thus the input signal is digitized. The digitized signal is stored in a semiconductor memory. The analyzer circuit fetches the stored waveform from the memory and analyze it to produce a variety of different information. The waveform reconstruction block reconstructs the waveform from the digital information and it provided to the vertical deflecting plates of the CRT. The time-based generator is a sawtooth waveform that is amplified by the horizontal amplifier and applied it to the horizontal deflecting plates as shown in the block diagram. Now the CRT displays the stored digitized waveform. So that's why this is a digital storage oscilloscope, which is mainly constitute a main parts from amplifier up to the waveform construction and give the all this input to the vertical plates and again input from the horizontal plates, and it will be given to the CRT. Now what are the advantages of the DSO? The digitized signal can be stored for a very long time. Signal processing is possible. Then cursor measurement is possible. It is applicable for displaying XY plots, PV diagram, BH curves, etc. So, and we can use the USB connection also for digital storage oscilloscope, which is not available in CRO, that is cathode ray oscilloscope. We can say that it is a updated version of your CRO, but still there are a lots of advantages of the DSO over the CRO. So these all about the DSO, that is a digital storage oscilloscope. If there is a question in the exam that explain the digital storage oscilloscope, we have to draw this block diagram, explain all these blocks one by one. Very simple blocks are there, how the amplifier works, digitizer, memory, how the sampler is work there, analog to digital converter is work, how the circuit is getting analyzed, the waveform construction and so on. So again we will deal with the digital storage oscilloscope, the working of the digital storage oscilloscope. So up till now in this lecture we completed the digital multimeter, function generator and DSO, that is a digital storage oscilloscope. Out of these three, maybe the question is there for the digital multimeter. then function generator and DSO. But for all these three topics, the question pattern is same. Explain a block diagram of any of these instruments. So whatever may be the power scope and auto transformer that we covered in the next lecture. So the question patterns are clear to you. So we'll start the next one in the next lecture. Thank you.